Good day, sirs, and let's play some Kerbal Space Program again for the third time. There's a couple reasons for that, and I'll get into it. One, there's been an update recently, which is really cool. It enhances the research system already added by adding in an economy system, so you can perform contracts that are sort of missions provided to you on a steady basis and based on your progress and your ability to perform them. And then you get money, and you can build better spaceships, and then you can't build too much, etc., etc., etc. So that's pretty cool, and they added some new parts that are also really, really cool, including the asteroid stuff to single player and things like that. But I wanted to talk about why I want to play this first, and it's because I'm in a weird phase right now, and I'm scared of it, because I know this is one of those phases where I would normally just stop recording for a while, and I'm afraid of that, but the reason is because this is the old research division, by the way. I'll load that in a second. The reason for that is because I can't really settle into playing one game, like, regularly. I can't, for some reason, I'm bored. I'm insanely bored, but I don't want to play anything for more than, like, I don't know, an hour or two at a time. So it's really tough for me, as someone who does YouTube videos, to think of irregular content or something like that, because I don't feel like that's what I want to provide anyway, is irregular content. But that's sort of what I'm going to do here. I'll talk about how I want to approach this in a minute. This is something that I want to show as a bit of nostalgia. This is the ruins, not really, this is our last Kerbal Space Program. It's given us money, but not very much, and you can see we made a great deal of progress in the research, but we never maxed it out. It wasn't really important for us to, and there's some new things that have been added. I'll cover those later. Also, the archives are pretty cool, so we can see what we've done in regards to experiments around the sun, and then we have done a bunch on Moho, and Eve, and even Gilly, and Kerbin, and it tracks all this stuff retroactively. So while the tracking system wasn't in the previous version, I don't think it was anyway, if it was, I didn't notice, it still tracks the progress that you had made in your previous saves, which is really cool. I think that's awesome. And then we could continue from here, and I'm still trying to make up my mind about that. But the only places we had not gone were Drez, Jewel, and Ilu. But we had done pretty much every damn other thing. And you can tell because there is a monstrous amount of space shit everywhere. There's just every kind of space shit all over everything. Look at all that shit. It's polluted. It's a catastrophe. But there's some pretty cool landmarks, too, from our achievements. Let's see here. We have the first Munlander landed on the Mun. Nobody in it. But it's there. Then we have the little brother, which I think was a science thing with a broken leg or something like that. These are alphabet, not alphabet, I don't know what these are. This is the Zenata, which was a probe that landed on Duna, I believe. Moho, that is. Let's see, we have the Hannah Montana, and the Hannah Montana Jr., and Junior Junior Junior, various different places. Pretty much all over the place, and the Bengal rover as well. Our failed attempt at a fuel depot around Minmus, so just a gigantic fuel tank rotating around Minmus. The Golden Coxploder's various debris. There's a couple of missions that are in progress, too, that I never finished. The Eve Lander. I don't remember what this one is, actually. Let's take a look at it. Oh, this was a probe, I believe, that was designed... I think it might have been attached to, or... Yeah, that's right. I think it was carrying a rover that landed on Eve, and this is the thing that's left in orbit. Don't really know what I would do with it from here. There's no docking ports on it or anything like that, so it's not terribly useful. But there's the other one. The other one that's in progress is... We left poor little Jeb high and dry in the Eve Planar Mark 1. And it's been separated here. I'm pretty sure the last thing I did, I didn't record this, but oops. Where's the other one? The last thing... God damn it. There we go. Last thing I did was transfer the fuel out of those... out of the plane section into these fuel tanks. Because the plane would not fly on Eve. It was equipped for atmospheric flight, but equipped for atmospheric flight in air. And I don't think the atmosphere in Eve is made of air, and I'm pretty sure the engines didn't work at all. So that was a pickle. But I did test it, and the game was crashing on me frequently the last time I stopped recording. That was one of the reasons that I stopped recording, was getting a little frustratingly unstable. But I do know that he is capable of returning. We're not going to do that, though, because that's a huge waste of my time. But there it is. There's the old Jeff Research Division. And I don't really see any reason to continue with this, because it would put us at a huge economic disadvantage. I have another game, though, going that is not very far along, but because we've done a great deal of the research and stuff already, it would be a little bit annoying to go through the process of landing on the moon and Minmus again, and I just really don't want to deal with that. So this save is one that I've started completely new with this version, and I had no intention of recording it because I thought I'd be done with Kerbal Space Program, but it's given me some ideas for things I want to do, and that's what I think I want to do with this, is instead of making every single thing I do and showing you all the progress, I think I'm just going to do cool missions sometimes that I choose to do, things that I want to do sort of creatively, but within the confines of research and economy. Now, this is the contract stage, or the contract area. You can accept a number of various different contracts of varying different difficulties. Some of them are trivial, some of them are pretty hard, exploring Dune, Eve, and Ike, for example. Some of them are very, very high-risk, high-reward, difficult things, like, some of them are also very improbable, like this one, to test a basic jet engine on the moon, which we know would not work, but you get a reward for trying it anyway. And that's the whole point of the missions, is not to successfully do something, but to try it. And sometimes you'll get really, really, really silly missions, like deploying a parachute at 200,000 feet while going 900 meters per second. Things that might very well kill you. But some of these other ones down here have massive rewards. This is a S3 engine cluster orbiting Kerbin. It's very big and very heavy and would be difficult to lift, but if you could, it would give you 800,000 Kerbin bucks and 248 research dollars and 516 star points, which are your reputation, I believe. They control the type of missions you're offered. So yeah, you can get some very, very, very prestigious missions. I've only got one active, and I don't know if I even plan to do it, but these are the ones that I've already done. Just tons and tons of them. Typical progress stuff. We've gone to the Mun. We've gone to Minmus. It's got a set of starter missions for you to get your funds going, and as you can see, we've got quite a bit of money. 700 Gs, to be exact. And the research state is pretty good. Been a little specific with what we've been going for. I was planning on doing some rover stuff. And the next thing I want to get, though, is definitely this. This is a new tech thing. It's the actuators, and it controls the advanced grabbing unit, which allows you to interact with objects in the world, like other parts of other spacecraft or asteroids, for example. So that's something that I want to do. And then there's a bunch of new parts, like this guy here is an LFBKR 1x2. I don't know. It's a huge fucking engine. Some of them are incredibly useful even in the early game. Like this is a S1. It's a gigantic solid rocket booster. Really, really big. Really fucking cool. And then there's all this other scientific stuff that, you know, will get unlocked eventually. But this would be what I would be probably focusing on next, because I want to play with asteroids. And I don't... You can... And I think I even have, possibly in this save, possibly in the other one, gone to an asteroid and taken a sample, but I don't remember if it was in this particular one. I'll look at the research thingy. Actually, I don't know where that would be under, so never mind. I know that there is, you can take surface samples from asteroids, but whatever. Anyway, get to the point of what I would like to do with this, and this video is only going to be for introduction purposes. What I want to do with this is to do a special mission program. So we've had the Jeff Space Research, or the Jeff Space Program, which was our first forays into space. Then we launched the Jeff Research Division, and now what I want to do is use our economic advantages to gain money to perform crazy, perhaps massive experiments, and then I want to hopefully start modding this and adding modded parts to it. I've explored a little bit of the options. Most of the cool ones are not available for this new version yet, but hopefully will be ported over soon. So yeah, that's the plan, and I don't plan on this being like an everyday kind of thing. because, like I said, I'm not in an everyday kind of mood right now. I mean, that could change any minute. It could probably change in the course of the next 5 seconds. But I love having this game to share with you guys, because it's just so cool and so much fun. Even if you guys are assholes and fucking beat me over the head. You don't know as much as Scott Manley. Okay, all right. It's fine. Good for him. I'll be crashing things into objects. Anyway, this I'll go over some of the stuff that's in space for what we've done here. Not too much. As you can see, there is pretty much jack shit. Those are some of the asteroids that are available for us now. I have not gone to Eve, Duna, Drez, Joule, Elu, or Moho. I've gone precisely to the moon. This is, that's Minmus. The moon. We landed there. Jeb hit the moon not too fast for once. He planted a flag and took off. And left nothing behind, I believe. Nope. Left some debris around from the Herpica. I'll show those spacecraft off in a minute. And then we landed also on Minmus. And I think there's actually an engine pod left over from us taking off from there. Let me look at that. Yep, that's an engine pod. But yeah, this is where we landed, in this little riverbed over here. And I believe we named this... Oh wait, there's two engine pods. Wow, cool. Double your fun. Yeah, this is Doodly Kerman landed here, and he doodly diddly did it. other than that, there's not much else here. So, there was one other thing I wanted to show. I forgot what it was. Oh yeah, the ships that I've used so far. Some of them are kind of cool, and some of them are pretty weak. This is the parts system that we have access to right now. I can show you some of the new parts, and then I'll show the ships that I've used. That's the basic command pod. These are the only pods we have access to. Again, this is not the whole part list. This is just what I've unlocked with research. This is the new solid booster. It is fucking huge! And look, that alone is a goddamn spaceship right there. of a fashion. Speaking of things that are huge... This is a big-ass fucking rocket. I don't know how else to put it. This is from the NASA parts pack, and there's some really, really cool parts in that pack from NASA. And that's about it for the stuff I've unlocked here. Again, there's way more stuff. I just haven't unlocked it. Standard stuff there. There's a bunch of new different decoupling methods as well. I don't think I've unlocked any of the advanced ones. Standard issue business over here. Nothing particularly new. There's some new science stuff, though. Some of it's pretty cool. We know the mystery goo thing. We've got the comms units, thermometer, barometer, and the science junior. And they changed the way that science works now, though, so that if you put a science junior on your little pod here, and then you slap an antenna on it, you used to be able to, even unmanned, send this to another planet and then use this over and over and over again with batteries and solar panels attached to a radio to do infinite research on whatever you were researching. Now that's not the case. This part will break when you have used it to transmit research once. So there's a limited amount of information you can get from probes. I don't particularly like that system, but it does add a level to difficulty, and that's something that I appreciate. This, however, is a dope-ass part that they added to offset that new difficulty level. It is the mobile processing lab, and it has a crew capacity of 2. I'm pretty sure it has to be manned to work, and it will allow you to reset broken parts. So you could do a mission to another planet, use this processing lab, and then radio in the stuff, and then jettison it, and then leave with your crew in a separate spacecraft, so that you wouldn't have to, you could haul this there and then not haul it all the way back. Still no reason to do research in a space station yet, but that's something that you might be able to mod in. I've seen some mods that address that a little bit, and that's something that I would look forward to. Now, the craft that I used for this, let's see here, I don't know which order that these were made in, but I do know that I started off using the Herpica system, and this particular craft is very strange. It looks like there's no fucking reason for this at all, but the reason was because I had a contract to deploy these parachutes and these solid boosters at a certain altitude. So this was not designed to go anywhere, but just to carry some gigantic boosters up to a certain altitude and airspeed and then deploy them. I think it worked. I don't remember. Obviously, we got money at some point, so And then there's this bad motherfucker. I'm pretty sure this is another contract one. Just solid fuel, a strap to a command pod. Gotta love it. oh yeah, this was really difficult. I had multiple contracts to send in crew reports, so I put an antenna on it, and then to do use these separatrons and one of these really heavy solid fuel boosters while in orbit. And I didn't have hardly any parts unlocked at all at the time, and so the only way that I could think to do that without fuel lines to make asparagus stock systems was to just put on more solid boosters. Really difficult. It did work, though. It was really hard, but fun. And then here's the last incarnation of our non-asparagoid launch systems. Pretty fucking sweet, as you can see. This was a scientific explorer, and I used it to do a mission that went, I believe, to the Mun and Minmus, maybe? I don't remember. But it had a shitload of these goo pods and a science junior, and it was able to do that stuff and return home with these landers, lander legs and parachutes, so I was able to get all the scientific data off of these devices. It was not a lander on other planets, though, so purely atmospheric stuff or orbital stuff. The Jeff Sparagus 1, however, was a lander, and, well, it still is. And this is the one that I used to land on Minmus and the Moon, the Mun, and it used those gigantic, awesome solid boosters and some other cool parts with a standard asparagus stock setup. Very similar to the Herpica, it's just, it's got an asparagus layout, so it's much more fuel efficient and much more versatile. I don't remember why I made Asparagus 2, but I'm sure there was reasons. I think, this is just less goo. And it's a little bit more refined. And then we had, I used this thing to make all sorts of different contract stuff. Like this one was just deploy parachutes at like a super low altitude. So this is just my template for using weird things. I don't know why this is called proboscis, but it's a little gross. And I think this is, oh, it's a probe. Okay. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I used this to get data from something or another like that. And this one had no practical purpose whatsoever, but it looked like a space orca. So it's a space orca. And the last one was what? The one that we started here. All right. So that's the program so far. Right now I have a contract to do a really boring mission. It's to use the atomic, rocket motor on an escape trajectory out of Kerbin, which is a little weird because that means I don't get it back. And that sucks because it's expensive. It costs $8,700 to do, not including all the stuff you have to use to get it up there. There's a pretty big problem with this current version where I don't know if they're planning on fixing this, but when you land a craft back on Kerbin, you can reclaim the parts in it. But if you have a craft and you have separators on it, the parts that you separate, you don't get any of that money back. Even if you put parachutes on those parts and allow them to stably drop to the surface of the planet, you still don't get that stuff back unless you put a probe head on it. And I don't even know if that works. Something I might test here. But anyway, I'm going to do this mission during this video just so I have something to do. It's just, we're going to throw a fucking probe into the middle of nowhere. Should be easy enough. I'll just make the craft and then skip over. It'll only take a few seconds. And then we'll end the video and I'll go on to doing bigger and better things, hopefully. But I did want to show you one contract in progress. And if there's any really cool contracts, I'll show them to you. But I'll just do this one as an example. Okay, so this is what I came up with. It's just some solid boosters, then a four-part asparagus, and then an atomic booster that will hopefully be able to eject it out into space. And the contract is here, even though, this is weird, it also tells me that the contract has expired. You go away. Look at this. It says the contract has expired, but it's still active. I don't know. I'm going to try to complete it anyway, just for fun. But this is a very expensive craft. I think it was like 35,000 Kerbin bucks. Which is too much for this mission, but I'm still going to give it a go. Just for the sake of doing it. As you can see, when there's a contract to do, there are conditions that have to be met. So what I have to do, according to this note, is to perform a test option on the atomic engine here. We could do the run test right now, but the conditions aren't met because we need to be on an escape trajectory out of Kerbin. which is a problem, and I also missed my gravity turn, because I'm bad. But in theory, this should be able to fling it pretty far out, hopefully onto something that will escape Kervin's gravity well, and then we'll just hit the run test and go from there. Maybe I'll even get the money back from the contract. Don't know. I don't even know if this craft will be able to complete the objective. I might have to make it more Kerbly, but I doubt it. Still remember how to do that orbital thing we do. Point it that way and go until the line says you're there. That's how they do it at NASA. They just follow the line. Anyway, easy enough to achieve orbit. Still though, not an escape trajectory, obviously. There we go. So we'll have to do a burn like this. And hopefully we won't run into any planetoids on the way. And that'll do it. That will be an escape trajectory. Just gotta hope we have enough fuel for that. Looks like only a 33-second burn, so should be fun. And fine. Oh, there it goes. Escape trajectory achieved. Now, we don't actually have to escape Kerbin. All we have to do is run the test. But I do need to decouple this first. Boop. And let's run the test. Whee! Test successful. And what we can do with this is we could, had I known or thought of this in advance, or known that I would have this much excess fuel, I would have known we could have simply just turned around, put a parachute on it, burned back in retrograde, shrunk our applesauce back into Kerbosphere, and retrieved the part and got some money back for this. But I did not think of that in advance. I didn't put any parachutes on it at all. And so it's just going to, at best, crash into Kerbin, at worst, be stuck in orbit. And I think what I'll do is I will leave it in orbit and possibly retrieve it later. That might be possible. I'm not 100% sure about how those things work. I'm going to have to tweak this applesauce a bit to get the orbit to be more, you know, awesome. But I'll get that figured out real quick. Alrighty, so we've got it at 100 bajillion meters per universe orbit, and that's a scientific term again, and we'll go ahead and end this here. Can't recover it, maybe gonna save it for later. So we'll go back to the Space Center and see if that contract paid out or not. It did, and it gave me a lot of money, so we're back where we were. We basically didn't gain or lose any money there, but we got a lot of science out of it, which is what we really wanted. And we lost a bunch of money and reputation, in theory. I don't think that actually did affect us. I think that was maybe a bug from me reloading stuff. Anyway, we can afford now to get the actuators, perfecting the art of making things mobile without the explicit use of explosives. Our engineers assure us this is actually a good thing. The advanced grabbing unit, which I'll cover in the next episode here of the Jeff Special Mission Program, where I am definitely gonna go start fucking around with asteroids. So, I hope you appreciate the reunion, and I'll see you in the next one, and probably in other weird random games in the meantime while I'm still feeling skittery about settling down on one in particular. With me!